now on Cokes TV News.
2024 is off to a cold and dry start for the most part. Maybe a stray sprinkle or flurry this morning. Otherwise, a better chance of showers as we go into this evening. I'll let you know what to expect for your New Year's and the first week of the year coming up next.
Welcome 2024. The New Year is here. How it was rung in, and can you keep some of those New Year's resolutions? New Year, more money. The minimum wage increase going into effect today in Delaware and where it'll be next year.
Flowers cuts it. Flowers has the angle and the touchdown.
Ravens rule the AFC, the win that clinched another division title and home field throughout the playoffs.
This is Cokes TV News Today.
Well, there it is, the iconic Times Square scene in New York City welcoming in the new year. And we welcomed in 2024 here along the coast with a tradition in Lewis. Got some pictures from the lightship overfalls and the anchor drop there. Dewey Beach Police Department, they posted this photo on their Facebook page. And as you can see, they had officers out last night helping people bring in the new year safely. Welcome to our 6 o'clock hour. It is January 1st, 2024. Happy New Year. Good morning. I'm Matt Pensick. Paige Marley is off today. And thank you for being up with us during the 6 o'clock hour. It may be a new year, but you know, as we bring in First Alert meteorologist Bob Trihe, temperatures, if you liked yesterday, you could probably like today too, Bob.
I think so. You know, we changed the calendar to a new year, by the way. Happy New Year, Matt and Delmarva. Yeah, we are seeing similar weather conditions. However, we are seeing clouds this morning and some radar returns, maybe a few sprinkles or flurries. That's about it. But seeing that eastern shore of Maryland up into areas of New Castle County and then Ocean Pines back through Golf Club shores and south, maybe a sprinkle or a flurry there. We have a little disturbance swinging through. Temperatures above freezing, so it's not going to stick whatever falls from the sky if it is snow. There is more disturbed weather back to the west. I promise there's a better chance of rain later today. Mid-30s inland right now, lower 40s along the coast, and we've got light winds, so not a bad January 1st. We've got the clouds this morning on future cast. Temperatures in the 30s, maybe a stray sprinkle or a flurry, but I think we'll see some sun as well during the day by noon, close to 50 degrees. Then the clouds fill back in as we go into the middle part of the afternoon with 40s and 50s, and then more organized showers build in later on this afternoon into this evening and during the dinner hour into maybe 9 p.m. So keep that in mind if you're out and about for New Year's as we're looking at temperatures on the chilly side today with a few of those showers. And I'll have your work week forecast and let you know if there's any major storms on the horizon that's coming up.
Looking forward to that, Bob. Thank you. President Joe Biden and First Lady Jill Biden, they brought in the new year in St. Croix and they took a moment to address the nation on New Year's Eve. While speaking with Ryan Seacrest, President Biden promoted what he considers the accomplishments of his administration and wished the public a healthy, happy, and safe New Year. First Lady also encouraged people to be kind to one another.
Well, my hope is that everybody has a healthy, happy, and safe New Year. But beyond that, I hope that they understand that we're in a better position than any country in the world to lead the world.
And as we move on, putting yourself in better position, whether you're looking to get in shape or drink less, another new year means another chance to meet your goals. According to one fitness expert we spoke with, the holiday is also a chance for local businesses like Midway Fitness to see a spike in profit.
Numbers have definitely gone up, especially since COVID. I mean, they're gradually increasing and increasing. So it'll be interesting to see if this January, it really, you know, has that kind of staying power.
And the gym says that people who begin a membership in January, they tend to stop coming after about 2 months. So this brings us to our Cokes TV poll. And this one is probably fitting for today. How successful are you with your New Year's resolution? So let's take a look at the updated results. And so far, 68% just don't set New Year's resolutions. 16% say they last about a month. 12% say they last a week. And only 4%, but good for you, you complete your resolutions. If you haven't voted yet, you can still do so at CoastTV.com or our mobile app. Well, there is information on public transit today in Delaware. It's New Year's Day, so there are no fixed route DART services. Also, paratransit not operating today. Everyone wants to go out with a bang on New Year's, but today's your last day for a few months legally. When it comes to fireworks, there are rules that you do not want to violate. In Delaware, sparklers and ground-based items can only be used on July 4th, December 31st, and January 1st. In 2015 alone, almost 12,000 people were hospitalized due to firework-related accidents. Penalty for getting caught with illegal fireworks is a misdemeanor, can also carry a fine. However, damages or injuries from fireworks, well, that can lead to felony charges. For a lot of people, New Year's Eve has an air of new beginnings, but for one local restaurant, the holiday was a last hurrah. The popular Sydney's in Milton hosted a New Year's Eve party Sunday night, and then today they're closing down. On a post on their Facebook page, they say, "This is it, our last dance." They also thank all their many fans for the support they've received over the years. Well, today's the day raises for Delaware's lowest wage workers. They begin, and the Delaware Department of Labor says the state minimum wage increasing to $13.25. This is an increase of $1.50 from the previous wage of $11.75. We went to Rehoboth Beach to get a sense of the impact of this hike, and well, here is what one person told us.
Some people have to work two or three jobs, and they work 80 hours or more a week just to make ends meet. That's not right.
By 2025, Delaware's minimum wage, well, it'll be $15 an hour. Lawmakers returning from the holiday break this month with a list of New Year's resolutions to tackle. Illegal migration at the southern border appears to have reached a new record. Ukraine and Israel are desperate for American taxpayer money, and as Amy Kiley shows us, another government shutdown could be looming.
The U.S. is ringing in the new year with migration and funding concerns threatening to explode.
When you're talking about 10% of the budget to allocate for cities on this, that's unsustainable.
Preliminary government numbers show record migration at the southern border in December. Texas Governor Greg Abbott says his state can't handle the surge, so he's sending migrants north.
They're being told that they are in the city of Chicago, literally dropped off in the middle of nowhere. I find that to be inhumane and unconscionable.
Likely, we will see more people die as a result of the inability of governments to really address the humanitarian needs.
In Congress, both parties say they want to address the border crisis, but Republicans say it has to come first. That leaves Ukraine and Israel desperate for aid as they grapple with new casualties and destruction, some just hours into the new year.
I cannot come back to South Carolina and talk about giving aid to Ukraine and Israel if the border is still broken.
And that's not the only budgetary battle awaiting lawmakers after the holiday recess. The federal government is running on stopgap funding. Without a deal, it could shut down in about a month. I'm Amy Kiley reporting.
Well, Ravens are the champions of the AFC North. Lamar Jackson perhaps locking down the MVP award through five touchdowns and a 56-19 rout of the Miami Dolphins. The win also gives the Ravens the number one seed, a bye, and home field advantage in the AFC playoffs. We'll have more on the Ravens' win later on Coast TV News Today. Don't get scammed as we head into 2024. The Milton Theater wants people to be careful after a would-be patron had an issue trying to buy tickets. The theater says this is an industry-wide issue, and well, here's what you need to watch out for. Now, according to the theater, resellers, they pay money, so their website becomes the first option on Google when you search for tickets. Milton Theater says the best online option to buy tickets is through their official website.
Happy New Year, everybody. I'm Madeline Overturf. Here's a look at just some of the things happening across Delmarva. In Somerset County, a dog was killed in a fire. It happened on Fontaine Road in Westover. The owner discovered the fire. He's okay, though his pet did die. An investigation into the cause of that fire is ongoing. Lanes will close on the Bay Bridge starting Tuesday. The MDTA says it's mostly on the eastbound side. Two-way traffic will be redirected to the westbound span. That's for preservation and maintenance, set to end Saturday. The Lewis Public Art Committee is meeting on Tuesday at 5:30. It's discussing possible action on Paul Daniels' pieces, the historical mural, and the DeWitt sculpture. That's a look at just some of the things happening across Delmarva. I'm Madeline Overturf. Have a very happy 2024.
Got more to get to in this edition of Coast TV News Today. Coming up, Bay Bridge lane closures, as Maddie just said. The impact if you are planning on traveling across the Chesapeake this week. Also, another Woodland Ferry closure to tell you about, the reopening this week, and another closure later this month. And artificial intelligence takes the stand with the Chief Supreme Court Justice's warning about the new technology. All that and more as Coast TV News Today continues.
Enjoy 10 songs in a row, brought to you by Pohanka Keir of Salisbury.
Have you ever felt leg pain, restlessness, cramps, tingling, swelling, numbness? If you've ever experienced the warning signs of bad circulation, then you need Legsercise Pro, the natural circulation booster that uses continuous automatic leg movement to soothe pain and promote healthy circulation the natural drug-free way. Soothe pain and calm restless legs. Reduce swelling in your legs, ankles, and feet, and stimulate healthy circulation. Stay active with Legsercise Pro.
Did you know enjoying social activities can slow down age-related issues? The key benefits are stimulation of the mind, improvement in motor skills, building interpersonal relationships, increasing confidence and independence. Home All Care Services LEAP program provides interactive activities that clients can enjoy twice a month at our Georgetown and Smyrna locations. Incorporating LEAP in your loved one's routine can create a sense of fulfillment and motivation. To learn more information about Home Well Care Services, visit DelmarvaExperts.com.
Oh, porches. Hello, aren't you the guy I see on TV, the porch protection guy?
Yeah,
I would say. So they're made of marine grade materials that last for years?
Yeah.
They say I could use my porch all year round?
I think
so. And they keep the dirt, pollen, and rain and wind out? And the custom made right here locally?
They are.
I got to run, but it was really nice talking to you.
Well, it was nice talking to you too.
Call or visit porchprotection.com for your free quote.
From the court to your living room, catch the dribbles and the buzzer beaters. High school basketball lives here on Delmarva Sports Network. Local teams, big dreams.
Just about 6:13 on this New Year's Day. Happy New Year. Hope you're doing well. Tidal Health Cam in Seaford. Mostly cloudy skies, dry roads. Can't rule out a sprinkle or a flurry, but temperatures are above freezing, so no issues with slick roads, anything like that. 30s and low 40s along the coast right now. Here are the clouds and also some radar returns to some very light echoes across the area. Down in Ocean City, that's where you're seeing a bigger concentration of some of these sprinkles, but along the coast, it's probably just liquid. Maybe a few flurries inland. Otherwise, just mostly cloudy skies. If you're going for a run this morning along the coast, we're looking at temperatures in the lower 40s to begin with. Light wind, so good morning for running. Make sure you wear that reflective gear. Sun's up after 7. Upper 40s by noon with mostly cloudy sky. All right, well, here's a chance to kick off 2024 with a refreshing start. Delaware State Parks are promoting first day hikes. Last year, over 50,000 people participated. Various programs are offered through, though some require pre-registration due to limited space. First day hike stickers and magnets, they're going to be available for hikers while supplies last. But best of all the hikes are free. We have an article on our website with a list of all the Sussex County hikes. Delaware Emergency Management Agency says it is ringing in the new year. It is doing that with the sound of sirens. Its test is scheduled for tomorrow, January 2nd at 10:45 a.m., Well, this is to ensure all the agency's safety measures are on point and up to date. Chief Justice Don Roberts is raising concern about artificial intelligence and says it poses a threat to the judicial system. He said while AI can increase access to legal information for people, especially those who may not be able to hire a lawyer, he also sees dangers with AI. He says the Judicial Conference, that's the body that oversees policy for the federal courts, will soon examine AI's proper use in litigation. BlendJet is recalling nearly 5 million of its BlendJet 2 portable blenders. This is due to fire and cut hazards. U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission says the blenders can overheat or it can catch fire, and the blender blades can break off. The company says it has received more than 300 reports of the blades breaking off while in use, and BlendJet says there have been 49 reports of minor burns, one report of someone getting cut. Well, still ahead, the Woodland Ferry to be closed today. Got a reopening this week. Got another closure to tell you about later this month.
And we're seeing mostly cloudy, mainly dry and chilly conditions on this New Year's Day morning. Laurel Camera and Tyndall's Casual Furniture, lots of clouds out there. Maybe a stray sprinkle or flurry, but grab the rain gear. More rain as we go into this evening, and more on and off rain for the rest of the week as well. I'll have the forecast for the first week of 2024 coming up next. Stay tuned.
With all the choices of services around Delmarva, where do you even begin? Trust experts of various fields offering the best of Delmarva, including Kitchen Concepts Plus, Chesapeake Eye Center, Apple Discount Drugs, Porch Protection Systems, FLC Energy, Spicer Brothers Construction, Mattress Peddlers, Homewell Care Services, Robinson's Jewelry and Coin Shop, Delmarva Acupuncture and Wellness Center, Mast Audiology Services, Riptide Restoration, Active Pest Solutions, Delmarva Day, Buchanan Subaru, and Floor Coverings International of Middle Delmarva. Delmarva experts, local experts, right when you need them.
It all started with a food truck, a truck and a dream of bringing excellent street food to our community. That dream became Tiki Jack's as we know it today. From mouth-watering street tacos to our signature sandwiches and street-inspired entrees, Tiki Jack's is the ultimate destination for comfort food by the shore. Whether you're dining out with family or looking for a fun night out with friends, stop by Tiki Jack's at Rehoboth Beach today for all your street eats and brews.
I fell into a burning ring of fire.
Tune to 100.9% Classic Country or download the app to listen anywhere.
Stanley Steamer, it's your home cleaner.
Welcome the new season with a deep cleaning by Stanley Steamer. Our certified technicians will renew your carpets, air ducts, upholstery, tile floors, and more, clearing away the dust and debris. We clean using powerful proprietary equipment and family-safe cleaning solutions to leave your space looking and feeling fresh. Call or go online to schedule your professional cleaning with Stanley Steamer today.
Okay, we're approaching 6:18 on this New Year's Day morning. In the middle of your screen, we're getting another live look into Ocean City. Bob, you and I were talking during the break. Food, big tradition, part of January 1st. I know sauerkraut, I think, plays a role in for some people. You were rattling off several others. Black Eyed Peas. I couldn't keep track of what you had going on there.
Well, personally, I don't have them, but my wife does. She's from the South. So Black Eyed Peas, cornbread, I think collard greens, you know, it brings prosperity and health for the new year. So that's what she does. I don't do the Black Eyed Peas. I don't know what they taste like, but I guess they're pretty good. They're probably healthy for you, I'm assuming. Make sure you scan the QR code right there, the lower left part of your screen. That will get you to the Coast TV weather app. Kick off the new year with brand new weather information on the app. Our average high now is 46. We're expecting around 49 for New Year's Day today, and then a cool down Tuesday, high of only 44, and it will be blustery. Upper 40s Wednesday, by Thursday 45, then by Friday pretty chilly, 41. So we are getting into the heart of winter with the first week of January, and this is typically the coldest time of year, so we can expect to see chillier readings, and we have those right now. Temperatures are above freezing, not too tough to take, mid to upper 30s, even lower 40s from Lewis back through Rehoboth Beach and Bethany Beach as well. And we've got a light wind out of the south. We've got clouds and a little disturbance is coming through with a few blips on the radar, maybe some sprinkles or flurries possible. That's about it across the eastern shore up into Newcastle County and then farther south, Ocean Pines, down near Chincoteague, maybe a few more sprinkles there. But that's about it. A very weak system. We've got a warm front to the north, but we have more energy back to the west. We're seeing snow across parts of Pennsylvania and the Ohio Valley. That disturbance swings through this evening and gives us, well, not snow, but a chance of some rain showers. So here's Futurecast of your New Year's Day. Clouds early, some sunshine mid-morning, upper 30s, and then by noon, upper 40s to around 50. The clouds close back in later on, and then that next disturbance brings us some showers 6 p.m. through the dinner hour, so keep that in mind. Winds pick up out of the north, and then after midnight, it starts to clear out, and it gets pretty chilly by Tuesday morning, down near freezing, and a cooler, blustery day on your Tuesday. Lots of sunshine, but highs only into the middle 40s, but feeling colder with the wind. As you look at the feels-like temperature this morning, feels like 30s, 40s into this afternoon, and then tonight, those winds kick in, and with those temperatures cold in the morning, feels like temperatures in the 20s, and only feeling like 30s into the afternoon. As far as rain chances, we get grazed by a system that mainly moves out to sea on Thursday. So we'll see some showers from that, but a more important system by the weekend. A storm comes right up the coast with rain, heavy rain, and maybe ending as a little bit of snow as we go into Sunday and Monday, but that's still well down the road. Plenty of time to watch that. Paul Davis, 7-day forecast, 49 today with the showers. Blustery and colder Tuesday and Wednesday, a few showers. Thursday, dry and cold Friday. And then by the weekend, 40s with rain later Saturday. Better chance of rain into Sunday.
All right, thanks a lot, Bob. DelDOT says that today is scheduled to be the last day of the Woodland Ferry closure. However, there is another one planned for January 22nd through the 29th. Sussex County Planning and Zoning will be starting the first week of the year with several public hearings. One of them is for land located here near Milton. It's along Route 60 and northbound Coastal Highway. It's across from the Rookery South Golf Course. According to the agenda, Ocean One Holdings LLC is looking to rezone about 65 acres from agricultural residential to heavy commercial. And county documents show that the developer's plan is to build retail spaces and a convenience market with gas pumps. The Division of Public Health is asking Delawareans for their input needed for the state health improvement plan. The division says it is seeking people's thoughts on health issues, vital conditions, and innovative solutions. Survey is open until Wednesday, January 3rd. Still to come this morning, there are scheduled lane closures taking place on the Bay Bridge this week. We're going to tell you what detours will be in place and what you need to know to navigate around them. Stay with us on Coast TV News today.
The Today Show, weekdays at 7 on Coast TV. At Draper Media, we offer more than TV and radio advertising. We reach your customers wherever they are, at the gas pump, in bars and restaurants, driving around Delmarva, in a taxi or rideshare at the beach, on social media, or searching for products and services, checking their email, and listening to podcasts or streaming video. Our plans fit all your business needs. Email Frank Hamilton today.
At Spicer Brothers, we're not just about installing roofs. We're about protection, durability, and peace of mind. Our team of skilled professionals can install your last roof using the highest quality materials in as little as one day. And we make it easy with on-site design and digital proposal.
And right now, save $1,000 off your new roof. Plus, have peace of mind with our Platinum Plus lifetime warranty. And the best part, enjoy no interest and no payments for 18 months.
Call today and schedule your free in-home consultation because you deserve the best.
It is important to have a supportive employer in your corner, a company that offers on-site healthcare to save you time and money. That's right, access to a doctor's office while at work at no cost to you. Work schedules to fit your lifestyle, matched 401k to prepare you for retirement, paid vacation, and more. A company that you can count on and grow with. A company that you can have a career with. An employer like Amick Farms. Visit countonamick.com to apply today.
Nice day for a white wedding. It's a nice day to start again.
Delmarva's classic rock, Big 107.7.
No break in the garbage pickup situation in Salisbury. City officials there say it continues to have unprecedented challenges with its trash collection. It's due to the equipment there. Routes remain staggered, and they are about 2 to 3 days behind. Now, crews worked Saturday to try to catch up. Some workers were emptying trash cans by hand. Salisbury officials remind people living in the city that there is no pickup today, New Year's Day, but a crew will be in place for January 2nd. Lanes will close on the Bay Bridge starting tomorrow. The Maryland Transit Authority says it's mostly on the eastbound side, and two-way traffic will be directed to the westbound span for preservation and maintenance, and it's set to end on Saturday. Well, we're joined once again by First Alert meteorologist Bob Trahi. Bob, I know some people, they actually like to go swimming in the Atlantic Ocean today. We actually have the Fenwick Freeze. It's taking place in just a few hours from now down in Fenwick Island.
Wow.
You going to take a dip in the Atlantic today, Matt? No? That's not on my bucket list either for today. And you said that takes place a little bit later this morning. So the actual temperature, the air temperature and the water temperature, probably similar. The water temperature's in the mid-40s. That's where temperatures will be this morning in Fenwick Island. At least the waves aren't huge. Won't be totally splashing you 2 to 3 feet. We will see showers later on this afternoon and this evening in Fenwick Island and Ocean City. Farther up the coast, we're looking at Lewis with temperatures into the 40s today. Some sunshine and some of those showers coming in during the course of the evening or after about 4 o'clock. And then Rehoboth, the same for you. Some sun, chilly today, and then evening showers as well. Much more on your forecast in the next couple of minutes, and I'll let you know if there's any big storms on the horizon for us. That's coming up.
Okay, well, after the break on Coast TV News Today, New Year's Eve for some, for others, a day to bring attention to the Israel-Hamas war. We'll tell you about the latest anti-Israel rallies that took place in the U.S. Also, today's the day Delaware raises the minimum wage for its workers, as some local businesses, some with them, say the increase is necessary. And the ball drops, resolutions begin. We'll tell you how your New Year's goals actually can impact local businesses. Coast TV News Today, we'll be right back.
When choosing windows and doors for your home, at Pella, it's your choice. We manufacture maintenance-free vinyl, fiberglass, and wood-clad windows and patio doors, all with lifetime warranties. High performance, energy efficient, and loaded with options to help make your house your home. Industry-first features and benefits make living easier and increase your home's value. Visit our experience center or call us today to schedule your free in-home consultation, where we bring the showroom to you.
20 years ago, Farmers Bank of Willards opened branches to serve Ocean City and West OC. Now, we're making it official with permanent locations to better serve our customers in Worcester County. While other banks are closing branches, we're banking on Ocean City's future. Sure, we have a world-class app, but sometimes there's no substitute for helpful, friendly people. Announcing our grand opening on 87th Street, North Ocean City, and coming in 2024, West OC on Route 611. Switch to the Farmers Bank of Willards, where people matter.
Hi, Chef Daniel Green here with my Bionic Blade, the new handheld blender that's rechargeable, so you can make a fast, healthy shake anywhere. It has the motor and blades built right into the lid, so blend a shake at the gym, make pina coladas by poolside, or grind coffee beans for an iced cold brew on the go.
Get the Bionic Blade for just $29.99 with free shipping. You'll also get 2 sipping lids, a second container, and the sports lid. Get it all for just $29.99. Order now.
100.9% Classic Country plays real country.
The closer you get, the further I fall.
6 days on the road and I'm gonna make it home tonight.
Tune to 100.9% Classic Country or download the app to listen anywhere.
Get live radar and severe weather alerts. Download the free Coast TV First Alert Weather app. Brought to you by Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling.
This is Coast TV News Today.
Well, this was the scene at Secrets in Ocean City just a few hours ago as people celebrated the start of a new year. And 6.5 hours ago, this is what the sky looked like in Ocean City, the town's annual fireworks display, signaling the start of a new year. It is January 1st, 2024. Good morning, everybody. I'm Matt Pensick, and it is 6:29 a.m. on this New Year's Monday morning. First Alert meteorologist Bob Trahi is back with us now to help you prepare if you're going out for breakfast or perhaps you're just returning from a night of reveille, Bob.
Yes, or recovering from a night of reverie. Yes, all of the above. Yes, I hope everybody's having a safe morning and a happy new year on this New Year's Day. We're looking at mostly cloudy skies and maybe a few sprinkles coming through, or maybe a few snow flurries, especially up in Newcastle County, maybe the eastern shore of Maryland, farther south, probably just a few raindrops from Salisbury out towards the shore right now near Ocean Pines. But that's about it. We've got mostly cloudy skies and mainly dry morning right now, and temperatures are above freezing, so no frost, no slick roads, nothing like that, with temperatures into the mid-30s for the most part. Lower 40s from Lewis down into Bethany Beach right now. Winds are light, and we're looking at futurecast this morning. It's chilly and cloudy, and we will be seeing a few sprinkles or flurries, but then they'll clear out. And I think we will see sun from time to time today. Temperatures warm from the 30s into the upper 40s by noon. I think we see the clouds increasing again by mid-afternoon. 40s to around 50 inland, a little cooler at the beaches, and we'll see a stronger system build in this evening with some rain, some scattered showers, so keep that in mind if you're going out to dinner or just out and about for New Year's Day evening. We're looking at some showers pretty much right through 9:30. So here is your checklist for today. Grab the umbrella for later today when we have the heavier showers and have the raincoat as well. Make sure you dress in layers. It'll be chilly. Make sure you have a warm beverage and have the sunglasses as well. We'll see time of sun during the day.
Thanks a lot, Bob. And well, whether you're looking to get in shape or drink less, another new year means another chance to meet your goals. But as Coast TV reporter Tori Seagrave shows us, your resolution also has more of an impact on local businesses than you might think.
Breaking a sweat on the treadmill or cutting back on the booze. The new year is all about becoming a new you. And businesses like Midway Fitness say hundreds join at the beginning of the month.
Our summer people, we don't see them because they work in a restaurant or they're just away or busy outside, and then they tend to come back right also around the same time. So I think sometimes we have the January effect, and then some of our regulars that have just, now that it's cold, they're not running outside, they're back.
Even liquor stores see an uptick in sales thanks to the holiday.
Yeah, champagne is top of the list because of the New Year, as you know. And we have, as you see, we have a lot of champagne. So we're expecting to go more and more than the last year.
But resolutions are hard to keep. The gym here says that people who begin a membership in January tend to stop coming after about 2 months. And at Lewis Wine and Spirits, people who are trying to drink less alcohol tend to only keep that habit for a couple of weeks. However, Patel says trends like non-alcoholic drinks have made it easier for people looking to sober up.
And we sell a lot of non-alcoholic champagne, beer, and so it's going to be there, here and there. But yeah, people are going to take resolution end of the new year. Nobody's resist without drinking, you know.
Finding ways to stick to the new you this new year. So whether your New Year's resolution lasts 1 month, 1 week, or just one day, there's a whole new year ahead to make those better changes for yourself while supporting local businesses. I'm Tori Seagraves in Lewis, Coast TV News.
If you need to take public transit in Delaware today, here's some information. New Year's Day, there's no fixed route, DART services, and also paratransit not operating today, Monday. Also today, more money for some Delaware workers as the state's new minimum wage increase is in effect. The Delaware Department of Labor says the state's minimum wage is increasing to $13.25. It's an increase of $1.50 from the previous minimum wage of $11.75. We went to Rehoboth Beach to get a sense of the impact of this hike, and here's what one person told us.
Some people have to work two or three jobs, and they work 80 hours or more a week just to make ends meet. That's not right.
And by 2025, Delaware's minimum wage will be $15 an hour. Well, everyone wanted to go out with a bang on New Year's Eve, but today might be your last day to do it legally for a few months. This is when it comes to fireworks, and there are rules you do not want to violate. In Delaware, sparklers and ground-based items can only be used on July 4th, December 31st, and July 1st. In 2015 alone, almost 12,000 people were hospitalized due to firework-related accidents. Penalty for getting caught with illegal fireworks is a misdemeanor, can also carry a fine. However, damages from fireworks, well, that can lead to felony charges. President Joe Biden and First Lady Jill Biden brought in New Year's in St. Croix, and the duo took a moment to address the nation on New Year's Eve. They were speaking with Ryan Seacrest, and President Biden promoted what he considers the accomplishments of his administration, and he wished the public a healthy, happy, and safe New Year. First Lady also encouraged people to be kind to one another. That message from the Bidens comes as many gathered on New Year's Eve to protest Israel. Demonstrators chanted and marched down the street in New York City in what was called a Shut It Down rally, according to social media posts. A similar scene took place in Washington, D.C., as protesters called for the United States to stop sending to Israel money to fund its war against Hamas. This is despite Hamas's brutal attacks on October 7th. They included beheadings of Israelis and also sexual atrocities committed by Hamas terrorists against Israeli civilians. In Washington, lawmakers return from the holiday break this month. They do have a list of New Year's resolutions to tackle. Preliminary government numbers show record illegal migration at the southern border in December. And in Congress, both parties say they do want to address the border crisis, but Republicans say it has to come first. That leaves Ukraine and Israel desperate for aid. And it's not the only budgetary battle awaiting lawmakers after the holiday recess. The federal government is running on stopgap funding, and without a deal, it can shut down in about a month. More news to get to in this final half hour. Don't go anywhere. Coming up, Rose Parade floats. They're on the move. We'll tell you more about the annual festivity scheduled in just a few hours. Also, domination of the Dolphins, the statement game for the Ravens' Lamar Jackson and Baltimore's division-clinching win. And Amtrak delays causing headaches for holiday travelers. We'll tell you what the company says caused the delays and even cancellations. Stay with us on Coast TV News today.
When you visit the Delmarva Design Center, you'll experience a selection of appliances, cabinetry, countertops, tile, and flooring all together in one showroom. The 10,000 square foot location has a variety of inspiring samples for any project size or budget. Your dedicated product experts and designers collaborate to bring your dream project to life. Come and see what the kitchen industry buzz is all about. Experience the Delmarva Design Center in Selbyville, Delaware, serving all of Delmarva's coast.
Start the new year off generously by giving to those in need on Delmarva. Coast Country and Spicer Brothers is hosting our winter clothing drive on Saturday, January 27th from the North Salisbury Wawa parking lot. Stop by from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. to donate new or gently used coats, blankets, or any warm clothing for those who need it most this winter. Join us on January 27th and make a difference in 2024. Coast Country Cares, brought to you by Spicer Brothers.
16 years ago, we founded Community Bank Delaware with the goal of providing high-quality banking services to our local community. Here you meet with decision makers, people just like you who live in and love this community. We provide the newest banking technologies to our customers, supported by our local team of banking professionals. Our bank serves clients throughout Sussex County, and we continue to grow, all thanks to you. Community Bank Delaware, where community matters.
It's time to experience an extraordinary lineup of entertainment at the Ocean City Performing Arts Center. Enjoy performances by the Four Phantoms in concert on February 4th, Wheel of Fortune Live on February 29th, The Simon and Garfunkel Story March 18th, and The Price is Right Live on April 1st. The excitement is building, and now it's your turn to be a part of it. Secure your seats at ococean.com/pack and join us for the most amazing season yet. Don't miss out. Come experience the magic of live performances all in one place at the Ocean City Performing Arts Center. See you there.
We're seeing a lot of clouds on this New Year's Day morning. Here's our Hershey Exteriors camp. Seeing a few breaks in the overcast, 47 in Ocean City. And those clouds could be yielding maybe a sprinkle or a flurry inland. Too warm along the coast where we have 40s right now. And then mid to upper 30s inland. So anything that falls will not stick because we have above freezing temperatures. Winds are light. We have a lot of clouds. And also some radar returns, Newcastle and Kent counties. Maybe some sprinkles there into the eastern shore of Maryland. And also a few sprinkles down near Ocean Pines.
lines back through Willards. Once again, inland, maybe a few flurries with this, but that's about it. Just a nuisance more than anything as we have a warm front lifting to the north. And by the way, if I didn't mention, Happy New Year. It is New Year's Day. Hard to believe. 2024, and we're looking at mostly cloudy skies today. Showers this morning. Better chance of showers this evening in a high of 49.
Travelers are recovering after an inconvenient day, New Year's Eve. Amtrak customers experienced long delays due to what the company described as major server issues. Bulk of the delays, that was in the Northeast Corridor train, but it also extended to Keystone service and Empire service routes. Amtrak warned riders of delays extending up to 2 hours. A few trains between New York and Boston actually had to be canceled outright. Powerball jackpot will now roll into the new year worth an estimated $810 million during the next drawing, which, oh, by the way, is tonight. It would rank as the fifth largest Powerball jackpot and the 10th largest U.S. lottery jackpot ever. Now, if a ticket matches all six numbers Monday night, estimated cash value would be over $400 million. Not that the odds are great. According to the Multi-State Lottery Association, the odds of winning the jackpot are 1 in almost 300 million. Big game of Week 17 in the NFL took place in Baltimore. The AFC North leading Ravens and the AFC East leading Dolphins. Win by either team would clinch the title of their respective divisions. Extra incentive for the Ravens, a win for them would also lock up the top seed and that coveted lone bye in the first round of the AFC playoffs. Ravens with a two-game lead with two to go at the start of the day. First quarter trailing 7-0. Lamar Jackson with his first touchdown. This one to Justice Hill, and we are tied at 7. Second quarter, Jackson takes advantage of confusion in that Miami defense. Zay Flowers, wide open, very wide open, and then, well, he's on the move, zigging, zagging. He's scoring, and the route in this game is on. What can you say about Jackson's performance? 321 yards passing, 5 touchdowns. Oh, and he had a perfect quarterback rating as well. The Ravens win the division title, clinch the top seed, and celebration was on.
AFC's best. AFC's best, right? Regular season, AFC's best.
It is the 7th division championship in franchise history. One more game remaining in the regular season. That's with the Steelers coming to town in Week 18. We head north on I-95 to the field in Philadelphia where the Eagles were home with the Cardinals. It was a great start for the Eagles. Second quarter, leading 7-3, and the Cardinals' Kyler Murray's throw is picked by Sidney Brown. And look at his speed and his moves. He cuts. He cuts again. It's a 98-yard pick six. Birds are up. 14-6. It was 21-6 at one point, but here come the Cards. Murray to Michael Wilson in shades of Jake Plummer in the 1990s. The Cardinals tie the game at 28. The Eagles would kick a field goal, but with just over 30 seconds left, here is James Conner for the go-ahead score. The Eagles did have one last chance. Here's Jalen Hurts rolling on the Hail Mary. It's going to be intercepted by Joey Blunt. The Eagles lose. They fall to 11-5, which means that they must win the season finale, the regular season finale at the Giants, and then hope Washington defeats the Cowboys in order to win a second straight NFC East title. Washington, speaking of them, they were playing out the string. They were home on Sunday against San Francisco. Second quarter down 10-3. Sam Howell, 3-yard pass. Terry McLaurin, hey, tied at 10. Fourth quarter, Brock Purdy scrambles, pointing, firing. He's got a touchdown. That seals the deal. Washington has not won a game since November 5th, 12th loss of the season for the Burgundy and Gold. New Year's is a time for celebrations, and one Marvel actor has a particular reason to celebrate this January 1st. David Daniel has that and more in today's Hollywood Minute.
It's a lot, really.
It's been 1 year since Jeremy Renner was nearly killed in a freak accident near his Nevada home. After 12 months of surgeries, therapy, and healing, he's marking the anniversary with a new musical diary. On Instagram, Renner called the album a story of life, death, recovery, all things learned along the way. Wait is due out today.
I've never been presumptuous about dreams.
Taylor Swift ended the year by setting one more record, most weeks by a solo artist at number one on the Billboard 200 album chart. 1989 Taylor's version just gave Swift her 68th week atop the chart, passing Elvis Presley.
I was the only Mormon in the United States Navy to wear a Star of David.
Guys, what the hell you got on as I'm the sheriff of the ship?
Legendary stand-up comedian Shecky Green has died. His wife tells the Las Vegas Review-Journal Green died early Sunday at his home in that city. Green was a Vegas headliner for nearly 60 years, working with everyone from Frank Sinatra to Elvis Presley. He was also a frequent guest on late-night talk shows, guest starred in TV series, and appeared in movies. Shecky Green was 97. In Hollywood, I'm David Daniel.
Still to come, Rose Parade floats on the move. We'll tell you the theme for this year's parade.
And we're starting to see a little bit of daylight on the horizon on our Gateway Subaru cam. Otherwise cloudy, maybe a sprinkle or flurry this morning as we start 2024. We are going to see a few showers again into this afternoon and this evening. And the week ahead looks chilly with no major storms, possibly something more significant this weekend. I'll have the details after the break.
I've always wanted to work with the acts.
This time around, we had the job of mentoring.
I'm very proud to have you on my team.
AGT Fantasy League, tonight on NBC and Peacock.
This is a real court, no matter what Yelp says.
Tuesday, spend the night.
Strap in, baby.
With family.
I'm not in favor of lying.
Lying is what parents need to do sometimes to build trust.
Night Court and Extended Family, Tuesday on NBC and Peacock.
With all the choices of services around Delmarva, where do you even begin? Trust experts of various fields offering the best of Delmarva, including Kitchen Concepts Plus, Chesapeake Eye Center, Apple Discount Drugs, Porch Protection Systems, FLC Energy, Spicer Brothers Construction, Mattress Peddlers, Homewell Care Services, Robinson's Jewelry and Coin Shop, Delmarva Acupuncture and Wellness Center, Mast Audiology Services, Riptide Restoration, Active Pest Solutions, Delmarva Day, Buchanan Subaru, and Floor Coverings International of Middle Delmarva. Delmarva experts, local experts, right when you need them.
Delmarva's rock station for 35 years.
NBC News Daily. Weekdays at 1 on Coast TV.
So, why do people open up differently here?
You are too much, Tamron Hall.
Reveal things they've never told before.
Ooh, Tamron.
I don't think I've ever said this out loud.
Do things they've never done before.
Let me take these teeth out.
So keep your light shining.
Because it's how she makes you feel.
Happiness, joy.
It's how you make her feel.
I love Tamron.
There's only one Tamron Hall.
Monday at 3 on Coast TV.
All right, it's 6:47 on this first morning of 2024. We're getting a live look now into Ocean City. So we're off and running, Bob, on the first day of the first month of a new year. Happy New Year's, Bob.
Happy New Year, man, and Happy New Year to everybody across Delmarva. We've got some color on the Ocean City camera. Great to see that. Hope everybody's doing well, and maybe you're recovering from partying last night. Be safe out there. We are looking at a, well, pretty nice morning weather-wise. Make sure you scan the QR code right there. That will get you to the Coast TV weather app. Could see a sprinkle or flurry this morning. Otherwise, for your New Year's Day, we're looking at 49 degrees. So chilly, but still above average. But tomorrow gets colder, 44. We're back to 48 on Wednesday. And then temperatures trend downward by the end of the week. By Thursday, 45. And then 41 on Friday. After all, it is January. We're getting into the meat of winter now. And it is typically the coldest time of year. And it looks like the trend for January is colder and stormier. And you'll see that in the extended forecast. Our temperatures out the door this morning, not too tough to take for the first day of January. 36 Delmar, 36 Seaford, 37 in Milton, 40 in Lewis, and 43 at Bethany Beach. So the winds are light. We've got mostly cloudy skies right now, and also a few sprinkles showing up on radar, maybe even a flurry mixed in with this. Eastern Shore of Maryland up into Newcastle County. Farther to the south, nothing across southern Delaware. Maybe a few sprinkles across areas of northern Maryland near Ocean Pines, but this is just a very weak system. We've got a warm front lifting to the north right now, and we've got another disturbance that's kicking off snow across the Ohio Valley into Pennsylvania. By the time it gets here, it'll be rain, but it will increase our shower chances this evening. So as we go through this morning. We'll see the clouds, I think, break up for a time, and temperatures still cold into the upper 30s. By noon, we're in the upper 40s, close to 50, and I think that'll be the tops for the temperature around Millsboro and Selbyville as the clouds fill back in this afternoon. And by dinner time, 6 p.m., we're looking at some scattered cold showers with temperatures in the 40s. So if you're headed out to dinner or just chilling for New Year's Day and maybe popping in a movie, watching football, we've got that. It is going to be one of those evenings to do that. We will see some showers continuing through about 9 o'clock, and then it clears out and we'll get into a colder flow as we go into Tuesday morning. It clears out, but we're looking at low 30s, mid 30s as we go into mid morning. Tomorrow it'll be a blustery and colder day as we go into your Tuesday with highs in the mid 40s, but with the wind feeling much colder than that. As we look at those feels like temperatures this morning, not too bad, feeling like 30s and then 40s this afternoon. It's as we go into tonight and tomorrow morning, the actual temperature coupled with the wind, it'll feel like middle 20s, so pretty cold. And even by tomorrow afternoon, those winds will stay into the 30s. As far as storminess, I think Thursday we get grazed by a system that will give us light rain with the bulk of the system missing us to the south. But then by the weekend, a more important storm comes up the coast with rain and wind and maybe enough cold air involved that it ends as a little bit of snow perhaps Sunday into early Monday. Just too soon to tell with the track of this system. But the air is getting colder and colder as we go through the month, so we could expect some snowflakes possibly with time. Paul Davis, 7-day forecast, 49 today, a few showers and some sunshine as well, 44 Tuesday, dry and chilly Wednesday, and then we get grazed by that storm on Thursday with a few showers, dry and cold Friday, but then the rain comes back stronger and maybe some wind as well later Saturday, looking rainy into Sunday and maybe ending as a little snow. We'll watch that.
Thanks, Bob. And for more weather updates, again, make sure you pull out your phone, scan the QR code for your First Alert weather app. You can download that app for free to get all the weather updates you need. Tournament of Roses parade floats are all primed and prepped for the 135th annual parade. It's later today. It's just in a few hours from now, actually. As you can see here, they are on the move late Sunday night in preparation. The parade kicks off before the annual Rose Bowl college football game. College football playoff this year with Alabama and Michigan, and this year's theme is celebrating a world of music, universal language. You can see the parade here on Coast TV starting at 11 a.m. 19th annual Fenwick Freeze. It's also happening today, New Year's Day. Fenwick Island town officials say the event will take place at 10:30 a.m. on Baird Street Beach. Registration begins at 9 a.m. It's $25 per person to register, and all registrants will get a commemorative long-sleeve T-shirt. Splash into the new year, take a dip in the Atlantic, or just buy the shirt to show your support for the Fenwick Island Beach Patrol. 6:52 on this Monday morning, New Year morning. Time to check out our Coastal Pet of the Day by Maggie's Pet Boutique. On your screen is a dog who is bringing in the new year right. Benny's one of our favorites. Always likes to get decked out in some sort of costume, and today he's excited to usher in 2024 with us here at Coast TV. Now, some may be opposed to wearing sunglasses inside, but we think Benny's pretty cool with that look going on for this New Year's Day. And we want to see more of your pets on Delmarva. Send us photos. Tell us what makes them so special. Here's the information on your screen where you can email us and then watch weekdays from 5 to 7 a.m. to see all of the pets we feature.
We're seeing daylight increasing on our Tunnel and Razor cam with lots of clouds to start 2024. Maybe a sprinkle or flurry this morning. More showers as we go later on today into this evening. And we've got a chilly weekend and a more significant system for the weekend. You'll want to take a look at the 10-day forecast. I'll have that coming up after the break.
Positive, focused,
supportive, and goal-oriented. These are just a few qualities of coaches who inspire their athletes.
Each month, the Preston Automotive Group will select a coach who makes a difference and make a $500 donation to their organization. Then at the end of the year, three of these coaches will receive an extra donation to their program.
Nominate your coach today at DelmarvaSportsNetwork.com under the Features tab.
Delmarva Sports Network, coach who makes a difference. Brought to you by Preston Automotive Group.
Take a grande, no foam, triple cap, double pump vanilla latte with 3.5 ice cubes, slightly shaken, extra whip.
Yeah, that's gonna be an upcharge.
Great! This one is on my Kasasa Cashback checking account.
Uh-huh.
Kasasa pays me cash back on everyday debit card purchases, plus refunds on ATM withdrawal fees. Go on, take back banking and treat yourself to monthly cash rewards.
Kasasa Checking is proudly offered at County Bank.
Your wallet is always in danger. Criminals can hack your information without you even knowing. Introducing Slim Mint, an ultra-thin RFID-blocking wallet that keeps your cards and cash protected. Slim Mint uses the latest RFID-blocking technology to prevent thieves from stealing your info. It's ergonomically designed to optimize space and keep your belongings organized. With the auto-locking Slim Mint, your cards and money stay securely in place. It has a built-in cash clip and a flexible outer band to fit your additional cards and cash. Call or click now and get Slim Mint for just $29.99. Order in the next 5 minutes and you'll get an instant $10 discount. So it's only $19.99. But wait, due to rising costs, this may be your last chance to get Slim Mint at this low price. There's a strict limit of 3 Slim Mint wallets while supplies last. Don't wait. Order now.
Call 1-800-613-4296. Call or visit slimmintwallet.com. So call 1-800-613-4296 now.
30 years ago, a historic ice storm knocked out power for 10 days. Trees fell across power lines and ice snapped utility poles. Our Delaware Electric Cooperative team worked around the clock to help those we serve. 3 decades later, we've applied the lessons we learned during the storm to make our grid stronger. Through the dedication of our employees, Co-op Power has never been more reliable. And while the weather is unpredictable, DEC's commitment to doing what's best for our members will never change.
6:55 a.m. and now some things you need to know before you go. And we welcome 2024 here along the coast with a tradition in Lewis. Got pictures here of the lightship overfalls and the anchor drop that took place from Secrets in Ocean City up to Orwith Beach and more. People were ringing in the new year on Delmarva. Today is the day for the first state's lowest wage workers to get a hike that begins. The Delaware Department of Labor says the state minimum wage is increasing to $13.25. It's going up $1.50 from the previous minimum wage of $11.75. By 2025, Delaware's minimum wage will be $15 an hour. The Ravens are the champions of the AFC North. Lamar Jackson perhaps locking down the MVP award. He threw for 5 touchdowns in a 56-19 rout of the Miami Dolphins. The win also gives the Ravens the number one seed, a bye, and home field advantage in the AFC playoffs. 6:56, time for another check on your forecast. One more check with our first alert meteorologist, Bob Trihe, on this first day of 2024, Bob.
Hard to believe, isn't it? Boy, I mean, the days go by. They say as you get older, the years go by quicker. And I tell you, that is the truth for sure. Our day part forecast, 30s this morning with clouds, maybe a sprinkle or flurry. I think we'll see times of sunshine today, but then also a few showers as we go into the evening. And happy new year. We are looking at mostly cloudy skies today with a high of 49, a better chance of those showers as we go into the new year. Here's the Paul Davis 10-day forecast, 49 today. Blustery and colder on Tuesday with a high of 44. Dry Wednesday, and then we get brushed by a storm on Thursday with some rain showers there. Cold Friday, and then a more significant storm takes aim at us later Saturday and Sunday with rain, possibly some snow. Then it looks like another storm later Tuesday into Wednesday.
So, maybe. I don't know, Bob. All right, thanks, Bob, and thank you for joining us here on Coast TV News Today. The Today Show is coming up next at 7 a.m., and then we'll be right back on Coast TV News Midday. Well, actually, we won't be because we have the Tournament of Roses Parade. That's at 11 a.m. Now, for more news and coverage, you can count on download our Coast TV News and Weather apps. Have a great morning, everybody.